welcomes you to the following presentation of the WNBA.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to the WNBA on 2K Sports. Our game tonight featuring the Washington Mystics as they go up against the Los Angeles Sparks. Alongside Tim Swartz and Brian Vanifatemi, I'm Blake Zuniga. Thanks for joining us. Tip-off goes to Washington. Well, here we go. Game one, WNBA semifinals. And one of these teams is seeing their first game of the postseason. Plenty of rest, and you can bet they've been watching tape of the last game of their opponent.
That's right, Blake. The competition throughout these WNBA playoffs has been extremely fierce. Each game has a magnitude that's amplified with the storm.
And you love the intensity that brings. Each game can mean the difference between keeping the playoff hopes alive and being sent packing. The shortest path to a championship, if you can end the regular season as a one or a two seed, would be to win six straight games. If you're a three or four seed, you have to win seven. And if you start the postseason at a lower seed, you got to win eight.
Yeah, I'm enamored with Tolliver's ability to handle the rock and make plays. It really only enhances her effectiveness.
Now here's Beard. Goes up on the wing. It's rebounded by Elena Deladon.
A real defensive lapse there. She's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot. They're lucky she didn't punish him there.
Here's Walker Kimbrough. Outside Atkins. Pass to Tolliver. Five to shoot. Over Gray. That one rolling around and rims out. And here are the Sparks now. Here's Parker. Now here is Ogumike. Excellent defense there from Elena Deladon. Pass to Misamun. And can't cash in from close range.
That's a surprise. Out of character for her to miss those when the D's not right in her face.
Over to the left wing. Back to Beard. Gray outside. The shot that time, not on target. Good D by Emma Misamun.
No, look this way.
Outside Tolliver. Here's the teardrop. The Sparks grab the miss. And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes played. Basket good.
Pays great attention to detail. Gray is alert and constantly looking for open teammates.
The Mystics trailing. Pass to Deladon. Here's Walker Kimbrough. She's covered by Brown. Six to shoot. Deladon with it. Brown's there. Deladon, no good. Just under 3.5 minutes elapsed here in the first quarter. Gray, left side. Brown. Over Tolliver. Off the left rim and out. Here's Walker Kimbrough, defended by Beard. Outside Atkins. Pass to Tolliver. Here's Walker Kimbrough. Back to Tolliver. Fires the three. It's hauled in by Beard.
It's been a bit of a struggle for her this quarter in terms of scoring the ball.
Gray outside. And here's Brown. Deladon covering. The jump hook. And it's Brown getting it to go.
Using her lengthy wingspan to her advantage, Brown is able to dominate down low.
And they're looking for some kind of spark here.
Yeah, cold stretch offensively. They need a bucket.
And Misamun gets it to go.
Hit the bullseye with that assist. Nice delivery into the lane.
side. Ogumike, right side. Gray outside. Rejected by Ariel Atkins.
Young and hungry. Can it get better than that? Atkins is a great fit for her team system and is simply willing to do whatever she can to contribute wherever she can.
Parker, good.
That's how to orchestrate for your teammate. Terrific pass.
And she got it!
That counts. Count it. Count it.
Just in time.
Some free points right there at the buzzer.
That was the definition of a prayer.
And it was answered.
A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. Sparks ahead. They lead by one. And we'll return shortly. Let's quickly break down the game we've seen from the Sparks. Guys?
A lot of tough D by them so far. It's been a difference maker.
Nothing has gone up uncontested for the most part. And look, that's why they've had success.
The Sparks with the lead. Parker with the ball. Outside, Williams. Mabry. Ogumike, Hawkins covering, goes up on the baseline, and the jumper is on the mark.
Gotta love the mid-range J. Shanae Ogumike has this in her endless bag of tricks.
Outside, Powers. Pass to Hawkins. Cloud with it. And here's Powers. Shoots over Williams. A nice shot by Powers.
Perfect screen there. Set her up with a terrific look.
Yeah, but that's a bad job by the defender to not fight through that screen to contest.
You want to see more effort there.
Now here's Williams. Pass to Mabry. Down to five on the shot clock. Here's Parker.
They're not settling. Getting inside for 8 of their last 10.
It's time for this defense to step up and stop these free runs to the rim. It's just too easy.
Pass to Powers. Over Ogumike. Powers' shot is off.
Well, for once a routine shot, she looked a little nervous on that release, wouldn't you say?
And she gets contact and the whistle on the shot. 2 free throws coming up.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
The first free throw is good. And she makes both free throws. Pass to Hines Allen. Sanders. Got a piece of it. And the whistle blows on a backcourt violation. Went over and back. And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have, staying aggressive and playing in control.
Rejected by Tiana Hawkins. 3 on 3. to Powers. Loud inside. Pass to Sanders. Outside Powers. Just five to shoot. Over Ogumake. A nice shot by Powers.
Got that one off right in the face of a bigger defender. Nice quick fire release.
Well, the mid-range shot really her only choice right there. She would have a tougher time taking it inside against such a bigger player.
Now here is Ogumake. Pass to Parker. From down in the low post, it goes.
They really settled into a nice groove offensively in the second quarter.
Yeah, and that field goal percentage zooming upwards. Would you believe me, Tim, if I told you now it's above 50%?
Well, of course I would. That's what the monitor says.
And I'm an honest man, too.
Here's Cloud. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change.
You know, they dug themselves in a hole in the first quarter, but they're starting to shoot it much better now.
You know, sometimes it takes a little while to work out the kinks, and they're starting to put it together like a puzzle right now.
And the Sparks call time here.
Well, they want to tinker with the game plan a little bit, and now's the time to do it.
Yeah, there was clearly some things going on out there that the coaching staff just wasn't a fan of.
Making some changes here. Now the Sparks with it. They've only given up six here in this quarter. Outside Williams. Ogumake. Pass to Ogumake. The jump hook. Basket counts.
A section of her game she has really worked on. Neka sees the floor well, sets others up.
Tolliver. No good that time. And the Sparks the other way now. Right side, Williams. It doesn't go for her. The Mystics trailing. Outside, Tolliver. Pass to Miesemann. Atkins with it. Now here's Tolliver. She's covered by Ogumake. Clock at six. Back to Atkins. Belladonna left side. Over Brown. Belladonna no good. Gray outside. Now Ogumake. He's covered by Tolliver. And that one's good. Ogumake.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
Everybody always thinks it's passing that gets you assists, but also their movement off the ball, it's created those opportunities.
Count that bucket.
A fluid decision maker, Tolliver knows when to take what shots, and she's just effective at reading defensive coverages.
Fades back. Ogumake can't hit. We're through the first half of play here in what's been a good one. The Sparks on top. They lead by five. Stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter going. Candace Parker displaying her skills today?
Sheer dominance in the post by her so far, just tearing them to shreds when she gets the ball inside.
And getting it to her is the only hard part, because once she's got the rock, she's automatic.
The Sparks with the lead. Now Gray. Shot from 12. And so she earns a trip to the line. Official saw the contact, and she'll shoot two.
Impressive growth from year one to now. Gray's numbers blossomed once she was able to really prove herself.
First trip to the line for her here. First one falls for her. And good on both. Now here's Tolliver. Deladon outside. Outside Atkins. Count that one.
With the steadfast and fiery offensive identity, Atkins is able to put her head down and attack.
Now here's Brown. Pass to Gray. Ogumike with the ball. Over Atkins. And that one's good. Ogumike. Here's Tolliver. 7-point differential. Deladon with it. Gray defending. She tries for three. Walker Kimbrough misses.
A good board there, but overall, they're getting slightly out-rebounded.
And they've just got to find a way to get back into this game. That's as good a place as any.
Just increase the effort on the boards.
Now here's Tolliver. Pass to Atkins. Here's Walker Kimbrough. She's covered by Ogumike. Outside Atkins. Shoots the three. The Sparks grab the miss. Ogumike outside. Neko Ogumike double teamed. Now here's Beard. Gray outside. Shot clock at six. From way back. Ooh, no luck on that one. And it's the Mystics taking it the other way. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, it's been a long time without a bucket. Focus.
Here's Nisimon. That one doesn't drop. Good D from Kalani Brown.
It just hasn't been an ideal start to the second half. They've missed three of their first four.
And out of bounds, the Mystics will take it. Here's Cloud. Outside Tolliver. Sanders. Back to Tolliver. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Not at all a bad passer for a 6'3 forward. Sanders with a great feed for the hoop.
Pass to Parker. Here's Vadiva. Looking for her first basket still in this one. Here's Ogumike. Hits the jump hook.
Dominates the paint, game in and game out. Ogumike is physical around the rim.
Outside Tolliver. Hawkins, she's covered by Ogumike. Out to the left wing. Just five on the clock. From deep. They grab their own miss. Deladon gets the bucket.
Cleaning up. Elena Deladon is a smooth scorer who isn't afraid of some dirty work.
Timeout called the Sparks. Third quarter of basketball here. A little under 3.5 minutes gone now. Outside Williams. And she can't extend the lead to double digits. Washington trailing. Loud inside. And aerial powers. Here we go. Pass to Sanders. That one drops.
That wasn't easy, but nothing about Sanders' style is full effort.
And here is Williams. Gray outside. Shoots from 12. LaToya Sanders grabs the board.
She just has not gotten into the flow of this game. But, yeah, her teammates have certainly done their part today. But she just hasn't gotten into the flow of this game. Tough to see. The teardrop is one of those, oh no, oh no, oh yes, shots.
A chance here to go 2-for-1.
But they've got to hurry to make it happen.
Take a good shot.
Now here's Parker. 8 points for her. And Chelsea Gray, here we go. And the Mystics making a change here. They have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have, staying aggressive and playing in control.
Tolliver with the ball. She's got 6. For the tie. Oh, no good on the buzzer beater. It's still anybody's game as we reach the end of 3. Sparks on top, leading by 3. And after a quick break, we're coming right back with the start of the fourth quarter. Thanks for joining us again as we get set for the fourth quarter. A terrific game so far. Cloud. Pass to Walker Kimbrough. And that's good. Off the glass that time. The Sparks with the lead. Now Parker. Ogumike outside. Outside Williams. Here's the floater, and she takes it up and lays it in.
Well, that pick, it worked like a charm. A nice job taking it right to the 10 for the layup.
Here's Walker Kimbrough. She's guarded by Williams. High post LaToya Sanders. Powers, 6 on the shot clock. To tie it up. Unable to get that one to go. We've played just over a minute here in the fourth quarter. The kick out to Williams. Pass to Parker. Ogumike. Here's Williams. Brown with Isaiah Sanders. And they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off. They got to score. Defensively, they're on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
And if they don't start showing some aggression, things are just going to get worse.
Now here's Beard. Outside Williams.
And the layup falls.
A sound distributor who loves to get teammates involved. Beard is the heartbeat of her team.
Time called here. The Mystics decide to talk it over. Parker with a strong contribution so far in this one.
I think I know what they're going to be talking about this time out. She's been taking it to him all game inside, and they haven't been able to stop her. They need to put up a better fight.
Deciding to change it up.
Cloud, Gray defending. Pass to Walker Kimbrough. And here is Misamon. She's covered by Ogumike. Six to shoot. Here's Walker Kimbrough. And another miss by Washington. Ogumike outside. It's Elena Beard on the wing. Back to Ogumike. Shoots over Della Don. Second chance shot with one on the clock. Back to Cloud. Atkins. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot, and we'll shoot two at the line.
A relentless note taker and film watcher. Atkins soaks up basketball like a sponge, and I think it's what leads to her success on the court.
So the first one drops, and that brings them within two here.
The seventh pick in the 2018 WNBA draft, Atkins actually made all-defense second team as a rookie.
Both good at the line.
She's got ice water in her veins, guys. No way she's going to miss from the line when the game's still hanging in the balance.
Now here's Gray. Beard outside. Back to Gray. Over Tolliver. And it's Gray missing. Side Tolliver. Pass to Della Don. To take the lead. Second shot opportunity. And she lays it up and in.
Huge bucket right there. Della Don is known for persevering through pressure-packed moments.
Now here's Parker.
A beautiful reverse layup.
Stay calm and collected in pressure-filled moments. Parker simply refuses to go down without a fight.
Here's Della Don. Down low, Misamon.
It's good! Wow, what a shot!
The moment isn't normally too big for Misamon. If her team needs her, She delivers.
And the Sparks call time here. Presentation of our Jordan player of the game, Elena Deladon.
Well, she's been a hammer on the inside all night. You see the power, the skill, the want to. Terrific offensive performance from her.
Now here's Parker. Pass to Brown. Now Beard. Shot clock at five. Fires for three. Rebounded by the Mystics. And they go to the intentional foul. Free throw is good, and that will put them up two. So she goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a three-point game.
That last free throw was critical. Their only choice now is to go for the three to tie.
The Sparks call timeout. Guys, what do you think?
They got two options. Take the three to tie it, or get a quick two, then foul.
And if it opens up for them inside, the quick two wouldn't be a bad call, but the foul has to come immediately after
that. It has to come immediately. You cannot waste a second.
To Parker, to the paint. Count it! And what a sensational bucket to bring them within one.
Well, she just craves the ball during crunch time. Agumake, a player who steps up when it's on the line. But you have to foul, but I'm sure they would have liked to foul someone different.
No other option, though. They did a good job getting it in her hands and making sure she was the one who go to the line.
Drops the first one, and that will put them up two.
The top high school recruit in the nation, the second overall pick of the WNBA draft, Elena Deladon. She's lived up to the lofty expectations that have followed her entire career.
And a tough break as her second attempt at the line, no good. Here's Parker. Gray outside.
Staying poised under pressure, Gray has the confidence and ability to come through in the clutch.
And the Mystics call time here. Your thoughts, guys?
Well, it all comes down to this. One shot to win the game. They have just enough time to run a play. They can catch the inbound, maybe make one quick pass, then they have to put it up.
With the steal, and they foul intentionally, and they're gonna have to do it again. They're not in the penalty yet,
and that's just what they have to do in order to get that ball back.
Yeah, to me, that's a good foul. Clock management, crucial at this time of the game.
And that's an intentional foul. He hits the first one, and that will put them up two.
Did you know Parker was the first player to win the WNBA MVP award and the Rookie of the Year award in the same season? I mean, what a special talent.
And so it's the Sparks who come out on top here. So that's going to do it for this one, folks.